think that spending the Shabbos and having the tremendous cover and the schuss of having Rabbi Rashi here with us, the Shabbos, now we understand that it's not that the Rav needs no introduction, but really, no introduction would be adequate. The fact that Rabbi Rashi came here and inspired us so much, I don't think that you can ever really fully appreciate and understand what this meant to us, the organization. It's a great cover tonight.
שבוע טוב, וחודש טוב ומבורך, כבוד הרבנים, מרנן ורבנן ורבותיי, וחברי הנהלת אש התורה, על כל הפרויקט אינספייר שהיה השבת, באמת בתודה רבה מקרב לב. אתם בטח מפחדים שאני הולך לדבר בעברית. הכי כיף, הכי נוח. About 15 years ago, I was on my way from New York to Latin America, or to Buenos Aires, or to Montevideo, South Latin America, a flight of about 10 hours. It was a night flight, started, because we arrived, because we landed, before we landed, was sunrise. I understood that I'm going to lose the time of Tfilat Shacharit, so ein brera, no choice, I had to pray alone in the plane. I took out from my handbag the Talis and Tfilin, put the Talis and Tfilin, a lady of about 50, maybe 60 years old, came to me, started to speak to me Spanish, and I showed her, I cannot answer now, I can't speak. Later, I finished davening. She came back and said, I don't speak Spanish. Do you understand English? Yes. What do you want to ask me? I wanted to ask you, what kind of EKG is this? Electrocardiogram on your arm, on your head. EKG, electrocardiogram, very seriously, very, very naive. What kind? I never saw such a kind of electrocardiogram, EKG. I didn't tell her I'm Jibrava, I didn't tell her Israel, I said, I'm Judeo. In Spanish, I'm Jewish. Every morning, we have a commandment from the Lord Almighty to put this, you call it again, we call it Tfilin. I had time, it's a long flight, explain that. Look on our head at the brain, on our arm the doings, deeds, close to our heart the feelings, the emotions. All of these organs, brain and the heart and the arm, have to serve the master of the universe, and inside of these two boxes, the first line is, listen, people of Israel, the God is our God, he is the only one. It's a declaration, and we have to put it together. Then the commandments, and then action. Whole story, how we were created as a nation, and we came out from slavery to freedom. All these items are in these two boxes written. She is an open mouth, Spirit properly, that I am also Judeo, also Jewish. I said to her, what means maybe, probably? You don't know. Doubted me. Tell me the story, maybe I can help you. She said, I was a child of 10 years, about 50 years ago. We lived somewhere in Latin America. Our grandmother was on her way to leave us. She lived in Buenos Aires, in a big home. The family was very, very wide and spread all over Latin America. She knew that the last day arrives. She asked all the relatives to come. She wants to separate. Dozens of people from San Paulo, from Rosario, from Cordova, from Lima, from Santiago. All of us came together from Panama. We came to Buenos Aires. She asked to move her bed to the living room. We were all in that huge room. She asked to put her elbows on the pillows. She wants to see everyone and to be shown by everyone. Now I know it was 15 minutes before she passed away. Her last words were like this. Children, dear children, I am going away. I am going away. I must separate. Before I give back my soul to the Lord Almighty, I feel my duty and holy duty to announce you something I never told you before. I didn't want to interrupt your career. I didn't want you to suffer of anti-Semitism. So I didn't tell you the story. My parents came from Europe many, many years ago. I was born already here in Argentina. But my parents were Judeans, Jewish. And I am Jewish too. I didn't tell you. Now I can give back my soul to the Lord, telling you this. I said to the lady in the plane, this mother, grandmother, was your father's mother or your mother's? My mother's. I said, welcome to the club. And I added, if this lady was your mother's mother, you are my sister. And the rest of the flight, we spoke what is Judaism. And I gave him the name in Buenos Aires, the rabbi, to apply for continuity. She didn't know 60 years who she is. What she is. Not that she didn't know what it means to be a Jew. She didn't know that she is Jewish. You have no idea how many millions of people of this kind live today in the globe. In Europe, America, South Africa, millions, especially east of Europe. Today is Rosh Chodesh Adar. In 6 weeks, we all will sit around the table of the peasant of night, Leila Sefer.
Like this
the 15 republics. Some of them in the Asian world, like Bukhara and Tashkent, in Georgia, they know what it is in Tashkent. But in the European part, in Odessa, in Dnipropetrovsk, in Ukraine, in Belarus, in Russia, many of them don't know that they are Jewish. So our task, this generation, I understand that Noah Feinberg said that Tzadik Levracha, why he was crying. Rav Shach said that Tzadik Levracha used to speak about the kibbutzim. The kibbutzim knew what is Shabbat. They knew what is Pesach. Sukkot, Shavuot was for them Chag HaBikurim, but they knew the day, they knew the Hebrew day. I speak about the Brits who don't know they are Jewish. In France, Germany, Scandinavia. So to conclude my words, I want to add one sentence. No, I'm not going to deliver a Rasha today. Like yesterday, because you have a very busy schedule today. Only one sentence today. Rav Noach Elbaumschmiede spoke today about the debate of Chazal, Shabbos Kuf Lamed Ches, Rav Shimon Bar Yochai, and Chacham. Rashbi said, Atira Torah Shetishtakach Mizrael. No, Chacham said, the day will come that the Torah will be forgotten. Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai stood up and said, no, we have a promise, ki lo tishokach mipizot. The Torah will be never forgotten. I want to add one sentence. Now is Motzei Shabbos. Can you imagine if an announcement given in Brooklyn or in Mons or the five towns, even in Connecticut, that there is a Tish tonight, Motzei Shabbos. Who is the Rebbe? Eliyahu HaNavi. We sing Motzei Shabbos. Eliyahu HaNavi, Eliyahu HaTishbi, Eliyahu HaGiloni. Ish, Sahu, Akko, Hashemu Eliki. This is the evening of Eliyahu HaNavi. He came, he's alive. He's immortal. He came to be the dish tonight in New York. Everyone would run. Snow, rain, winds, doesn't matter. Everyone will go to listen and Dvar Torah from the Eliyahu HaNavi. I have for you an easy way. You don't have to rush, you don't have to run, you don't have to climb up. If you want to hear the Dvar Torah from the Rebbe, the Eliyahu HaNavi, he left us his Torah in the book. Tana Devei. What was said in Besa Medrash of Eliyahu HaNavi. His quotations, word by word. His Talmidim wrote what Eliyahu HaNavi said. One sentence he said there that for me changed my life since I was a yeshiva boy. Before I joined Hever HaPe'ilim to go to work with the new Olim from Yemen, from Morocco, Tunisia, Algeria, Iran, Iraq, Syria, Lebanon, who came to Eretz Israel. Some of them didn't know anything. Some of them knew, but they thought that they had to keep Shabbat or Kashrut only abroad, in Kutzlar, among the Goyim. Not to be like the Goyim, but in Eretz Israel, we are Yidden without Shabbat. We are Israeli without Kashrut. We don't need Talis and Phil. We can get rid of them. We are Israelis That's what some people told them. And we went to work with them to tell them, Shpabelinu Saramisa, Altitosh Noratki Mesa. This is our heritage. Don't give a guess to me. He had Chayenu. What inspired me to do it? To go from Kultoyle, from Polovich, to go to Chelet, to Dimona, to Hebel Achish, on Shabbatot. One sentence from Tana de Beria. What is it? Maybe for some of you it will be a discovery. What Eliyahu HaNavi told us. We know from the Gemara Shabbat that after 120 years, when we can come up to Beis Shemaya, the Rebbe Mishnah will ask each of us 6 questions. Kavata itim etoel? Did you learn? Davayomim otem? Nasaka venatata beemuna? Your business. You were honest. You didn't cheat people. You didn't lie. You didn't steal. 6 questions. Tana de Ve'eliyahu brings, tells us, of behind the kulisses. He is alive. He climbed up on a fire, on a flame, way to heaven. And he tells us, when we arrive there to Beis Shemal, we will be asked each of us 1 question more, a 7 question. Ma'asita, what did you do? Shelot ishtakach Torah miYisrael. The Torah will not be forgotten from the people of Israel. What did you do? Each of us, ladies and gentlemen, in all the ages, when we arrive there, be prepared to answer this question. Some of us will say, I have no talents, I'm not a speaker, I'm not a narrator, I couldn't inspire other people. I'm not. But you could pay for it. Cover the expenses. For those who can do it, who must do it, and try to do it, you have financial means. But the second one will say, I have not even financial means. I'm not a public home. I'm not a scholar. And I'm not a great businessman. How is it I bring food to my family? What do you want me to do? A pair of hands you have? To build a chair? A carpenter you are? To do something? A furniture? For those who study? For those who teach? There is no human being who is free of this duty to do something in order that the Torah will not be forgotten. Everyone will have something to do, to contribute, a pledge, to be a driver, to bring the students to the rabbi, to take the rabbi to the students, whatever. Please, ladies and gentlemen, before we separate, it's a beautiful Shabbat. Remember the words of Yohanan. This is my obligation and commitment. Many, many years. Maybe 60 years. But I can never forget it. I remember it every day. Every day. Tana de Ve'eliyahu gave us a maton, a present. I tell you, confidentially. I was there, behind of the kulisses. I want to tell you, be prepared. They will ask, the British children will ask each of you, Ma asita, shelot ishtakach Torah miYisrael. What did you do? Did you support the activities of Asia Torah? Yes, you did. Welcome aboard. Open chest. The gates of paradise will be open for you because you are a part of this inspired project. So if you are a part of it, you are Ben Olam Haba, and you deserve to be a part of Kabbalat Pnei Mashiach in the Rabbi Yameinu Kulam.